But they were French. How do you know the French? Yeah. They decided we had a Ford engine, which was the best engine. The cars were Ford. And they decided they wanted to have a French engine. So they had a French engine. I decided I couldn't drive the French engine. It wasn't going to be successful in my head. So Ken Tyrrell started to make his own car, the Tyrrell Ford, which I won two world championships with after I won the world championship with the Matra, with the Ford engine. So my life now is, of course, not with as a driver. I retired after I had done only 99 Grand Prix. I mean, today the drivers are doing many, many more. I didn't do my 100th Grand Prix because my teammate, unfortunately, got killed on the Saturday when the race was on Sunday. And out of respect, I decided not to race on Sunday. I had already decided to retire on what would have been my 100th Grand Prix. I thought it was a good time to stop. I was 34 years of age and still able to do other things. So one of those other things is being with Rolex. I've been with Rolex now for 51 years, going around the world with them. Such a great product, a great company to be part of. I'm also, I have 50 years with Moët and Chandon, the champagne company, because I was the first to spray champagne in Formula One. The Count Frederick Chandon was at the French Grand Prix in Clermont-Ferrand. The president of France presented me with a trophy because I won the race. And then there was a bottle of champagne sitting in the podium, which had been there for the whole race. And it was 31 degrees of temperature, 35 degrees of temperature. And when we opened the cork, it exploded. I mean, it just shot up. Being Scottish, I wanted to save the champagne. So I put my thumb on the champagne. And of course, it went further. And that was the beginning of spraying champagne, because when I started to win a lot of races, I could have hit that man at the end of the room with a bottle of champagne, because once you get the hang of it, you can almost do anything with it. So I've spilled considerably more champagne than I've ever consumed. But it's a nice company. And I'm still with them. So my relationships have been long term. I was with Ford Motor Company for 40 years. And they took me around the world because they're a global company. So motor racing is very good for that. Racing drivers have something to do after they decide to be no longer racing drivers. If I had been an athlete or a gymnast, I would have had a little pair of shorts, I would have had shoes, and I would have had a t-shirt. Not much commercially after you retire. A racing driver has the motor industry, has the fuel and oil companies, has the tire manufacturers, and Rolex. So therefore, motorsport is lucky for those who wish to retire, because there's usually a life beyond driving.